theatres aren't supposed to be quiet, but the pandemic has kept bums off seats and pushed venues towards the brink financially. Now, after months on tenterhooks, places like this could get a grant to stay afloat.
I am feeling, in my heart, enormously relieved, because we really didn't expect to get a settlement of this scale, and that's really important to say. It is a lot of money. But in my head, I'm having to maintain caution because there is still a long way to go and a lot of questions to be answered.
Because with social distancing rules, it's no clearer when the curtain will raise again and live indoor performances will get the go-ahead. Christopher Biggins was booked up for pantomime this winter.
Book your tickets now.
From the cast to the technical team to the theatre itself, they're all in limbo.
We need to have a date, a timetable to be announced when the theatres can reopen, because the theatre makes so much money during a pantomime, it allows them to live for the rest of the year. So there is a big, big problem.
It's hard to swallow when this was the scene in London's West End on Saturday. Crowds drinking in the streets, right outside shuttered theatres. The Culture Secretary at Shakespeare's Globe today can only say they'll open as soon as it's safe and insist the arts are a priority.
Think of all the tourists who come here, but also think of all the children, all the adults who come here for the first time, whose lives are enriched by that culture. So all of those factors have contributed to us going for a very big level of support, really to help our institutions weather this storm.
But the money won't help the artists who are already out of a job. There are fears of a talent drain from the industry. And there are questions too about how the grants will be allocated and who to. John promotes music gigs at grassroots venues.
It's always the biggest problem, how much is our arts and culture worth compared to their arts and culture? How do you compare a gig at a small venue to a play at a national theatre? I don't know, it's very hard to prove.
Today's news is being greeted with a muted applause. And without a timetable for return, the real cheers will have to wait. Tessa Chapman, 5 News in Kingston.